friends, today I, Akar Singh, is here with a topic from grade 7th maths, rational numbers. So let's start with what we have to learn today. So today our learning objectives are introduction to rational numbers and rational numbers on number line. So let's start with introduction to rational numbers. So for what do you mean by rational numbers? A number which is in the form of PQ, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0, is called rational numbers. P is the numerator and Q is the denominator. So let's start with positive and negative rational numbers. Differentiate. Positive rational number. If both the numerator and denominator are either positive or negative, the rational number is said to be positive rational number. For example, you can see 2 upon 3 minus 45 upon minus 55. These are examples of positive rational numbers. Now, the next topic is negative rational number. If either numerator or the denominator of a rational number is negative, the rational number is said to be negative. For example, minus 5 upon 9 and minus 79 upon 99. These are examples of negative rational number. So let's proceed with representation of rational numbers on number line. In previous classes, we have learned representation of integers on number line. Now we will learn about the positive rational numbers and negative rational numbers on number line. Positive rational number lie on the right side of the zero and negative rational numbers lie on the left side of the zero. For example, you can see here, this is zero, this side, left, right side, positive rational numbers, right, left side, negative rational numbers. So you may be clear about representation of rational numbers on number line. So let's proceed with some practice. So first question is, for what value A, the number minus 11 upon A is not a rational number? So it is asking what value should be in the A position so it will not become a rational number. So you can see first option is minus 1. So if we will put minus 1, it will be a rational number. If we will put 1, it will also be a rational number. But 0. In 0 case, when we will put 0, when the denominator becomes 0, the number is not a rational number. So the right answer is 0. So the second question is, fraction are in the form of PQ, where P and Q are dash. So this we have discussed in the video, that when the fractions are in the form of PQ, the PQ are integers. So you may be clear about what we have learned. So let's proceed with practice with pen and paper. So let's practice what we have learned with a pen and a paper. So the first question is, classify the rational number as positive or negative rational number. So the first part is minus 22. So the number is in negative, so the rational number is negative. See the second part. Both the number are negative. So if you remember the rule of positive rational numbers, if the both numbers are positive or either both are negative, so the number is positive. So the answer will be positive. So the next part is here, minus 100 upon 210. So one number in this is negative,
So the answer will be negative. In the next part, both numbers are positive. So the number will be positive rational number. Let's go to next question. The question is, represent the rational number as on number line. So the first part we will do first, that is 5 by 2. The fraction is in improper fraction. So we will first convert it into proper fraction. We will convert 5 by 2 into proper fraction. So firstly we will divide it by 2. The 2 to the 4. 1 is the remainder, 2 is the quotient, and the 2 is the divisor. So it means 2 whole and 1 by 2. So if you can see that 2 1 by 2, that means 2 and half. So it will be in between 2 and 3, positive. So firstly we will make a straight line with the help of a pencil and a scale. We will make a straight line so firstly we will make a zero in between, then we will put the right side positive numbers, left side negative numbers, so this number is 5 by 2, which means 2 wholes and 1 half. So it will be somewhere here, 2, 1 by 2. So we will circle it and we will write a line. Thus, rational number is represented on a number line. Number line. So our question first part is complete. So we will move on second part, which is minus 3 upon 3. So the second part is minus 3 upon 3. We will represent this on number line. So the one of the number is negative. So the number will be negative and it will come on the left side of the zero. So we will make a straight line again. Then we will mark zero. This side positive numbers. This side negative numbers. So we will write here minus 1 upon 3. here minus 2 upon 3 and minus 3 upon 3. If we will cut minus 3 upon 3, it will become minus 1. So the answer is minus 1. So we will write a line here. On a number line. So our today's video is complete. We will be keep coming with other videos. Thank you so much.